Hey folks, Rick Naguiluto here. Today I'm going to be painting a full moon just like that one. The colors I'll be using are ultramarine blue, yellow ochre, and burnt amber. I've made a quick sketch where my moon's going to be more or less, and the piece of land, but I'm going to cover all of this up anyway, so don't worry, I'll show you how as I go along. I'm going to start mixing my colors now. As usual, I like to mix more than I need, so in case I run out, I don't have to redo the whole thing again. Add a bit of yellow ochre. Not too much, so it doesn't become green. And I think I just got it. And to darken a little bit more, I'll use a bit of the burnt umber. I'm going to divide this mixing in about half piles. This one to be lighter, and this one I'm going to make a darker with the rest of the burnt umber. That'll be on night sky. Okay, done. I am now gonna pass my mixtures into my palette. I like to mix it here because there's more space, but you can at home, you can do it as you please. I'm going to put the darkest blue here and then slowly make a color string of lighter tones values. I'm going to add a bit of white here now, and I'm going to make a third and lighter value. Stick a little nib of this, mix it right here. Two more white piles here. Titanium white, just like that one. And this is the palette knife from mixing this one. Just taking a little bit out of that color. Mix in here, make a fourth value even lighter. Add a bit more white to that one. And now without cleaning my palette knife, I just move straight to this pile of white here and use the rest of the blue that was in the palette knife. So it's not pure white. Just want a very, very light blue. So now we have nice piles of five different values from dark to lightest, and this is just about all I'm going to be needing to make our painting. Okay, now using a pretty wide brush, this is about 2 fingers wide. I could give you the number, it's 16, Rosemary & Company, series 2015. But since every different brush company has different sizes, they don't have an international regular limitation for different sizes, so it gets confusing. So it's better that you just see that this is about 2 fingers wide, and it's animal bristles, hog hair, or maybe chunking. And I'm gonna start covering this top part. Make sure you don't leave any white spots coming through. And if you do, don't worry. You can tell someone that they're stars. I usually give it 2 coats. Because as you can see, or maybe you can't see, but I can see white coming through anyway. Even though I'm applying quite a bit of paint. Just to be on the safe side, maybe it's better to just do it twice. Okay, now that this part is dry, I'm gonna do from dark to light. Another coat. I'm spraying lightly because it'll make it easier to blend after. I'm gonna go to the second pile here, slightly more blue. Not adding much, just a little bit. Maybe this is too much actually. Take a bit off. I zigzag like this, it helps to blend just up and down. See? Again from the bottom. My brush. And again, from the bottom up. Just a little bit more from the bottom and then up. This part, if you're having difficulty, you have to try to do as fast as possible so it blends smoothly. Don't worry, if you don't get it the first time, just keep trying. Wipe the paint excess. As you go up, try and do a little bit lighter touches so you don't disrupt too much of this dark color. Back up. There. Voila. Now just let it dry or use a hair dryer. Okay, what I'm gonna do now is draw the circle. And to do that, I'm using a compass and a watercolor pencil that I have tied to my compass. You can use a pencil, but with a watercolor, especially white, you'll be able to see a lot better. To this side, more or less. Where my moon's gonna be. And use what you have to make the circle. Even a pot will probably work. Or a small plate. This is about the size of a small dessert plate. So use that if you don't have a compass. Now what I want to do is mark more or less where I want my landmass to be. Just roughly, you can change that after. Now the technique to make this moon, basically, it's scumbling and glazing. So it's a lot of scrubbing. Very, very small amount of paint. So the secret here basically is patience and time. You have to put the time. If you try to make it too quickly, it won't be translucent. It'll just be thick paint and you'll see the difference. So for now, I'm gonna use the darks that are already here and I'll probably add some more where I need it. But what I wanna do now basically is bring in the light. So from dark to light and just basically mark the largest shapes, the darkest ones. So I'm using this photo on my iPad, but you'll have the same one here. Here'll be the moon belly buttons about here. You can do this with a paintbrush also, you don't have to have a watercolor pencil. This one's actually not working very well, I might just use a brush. I think I'm gonna do that. I don't know for what reason, it usually works really well. I'm just gonna grab a brush and do it with a brush. Look for large shapes and define them. It's a little too rough, this brush, so I'm gonna change it to a synthetic, which will be a lot smoother and dilute the paint quite a bit. See? About this size. That's better. As I said, I'm just marking the largest shapes I can see. Don't worry about being perfect. Okay, I think I'll do for now. Okay, now that I've marked all these shapes, I'm going to start scumbling, rubbing the paint in very thin, diluted layers. And I put just a very little bit on a brush. This is about the size, you can compare it to my finger. And it's hog hair, so I can really scrub it. And now just watch, because you'll see, I'm going to be building up layers, but the technique is always the same. Have a piece of paper and close by, so if you see that you put too much paint, you just take it off. Here, since this is the belly button of the moon, as you can see in the photo, it has these long flowy lines, so it's good that as you scumble, you try and follow that pattern. See what I mean? Towards this center. And to be careful with the edges, I usually define, and I think I'm gonna do that now, just define a little bit better the edges of the moon. So with the losers, this is a watercolor pencil. Whenever I scumble over there, it's gonna erase it. So it's better to put it with acrylic. Just maybe even darker. Just follow the line. Try not to breathe while you're doing this, or knock the camera. I mean, you do have to have a perfect circle, otherwise it's gonna look really weird. Turn this around. It's easier like this. As you see, I'm starting from the inside towards the outside so I don't go over it. I suggest you also flip it, or you'll find that it's a lot easier to follow this line. You make a mess of your circle, just grab the compass and open it up a little bit more and you redraw a new line. Yeah, it looks a little funny. Will do for now. Just remember not to put thick paint. Try and dilute it. It's better to have many layers than one thick one. I see a bit of water like this mixed with the paint. That's just about good. Oh, perfect. And lots of layers showing through. Sorry, this is going to be a little bit shaky since I'm scumbling. I'm trying to hold the easel in place. I did the best I can here. But you get the picture. Not to worry too much about this part. I'm doing it just in case some of you might want to have the full moon as it is, but I'm gonna chop here with a piece of land. Just in case you don't want to put any land here, I'll try and do the whole moon first. Too much paint. Need to be patient. It'd be a lot easier to just put a whole bunch of white there, but then it wouldn't be translucent. You wouldn't have all this glow in the end. This is one of the dark parts of the moon, so be careful not to make it too light, even though I'm going to go back to the darks after. I'm trying to find a middle ground here right now. We're going to have to get rid of all these hard edges. And by that, we're gonna have to go back to the darks. And very soft transitions between dark and light shapes. Here's the dark again. I'm gonna change to a smaller brush now. See the difference? This one's a little bit less. This one is a number 6 on Rosemary and Company, but you can find something similar, slightly smaller than our previous brush. I'm going to be going from dark to light using both of these where I find it that it's needed. That'll help me get rid of all these edges. Resetting the darkest parts again. Basically, you can see we're going back and forth. Light to dark, dark to light, light to dark, dark to light. quite a light point here. It's about there. Another one there. Then another one. Just there. Shut your eyelids and the forms, the details will disappear. Well, they won't disappear, but they'll become less pronounced. So it'll be easier for you to see the larger shapes. In this case of the dark parts or light parts of the moon. It's a little trick that you can use. These are not definite lines. It's just a guideline for me. I'm aiming as if the sun, of course, is hitting it full, since it's full moon, but the main brightness in this moon will be around this area here on the edges. So, as you can tell, our edges are a lot softer now. The transition between the lights and the darks. So now we can move on to a lighter shade, like this one. Start bringing the glow out. Whoops. think now I'm gonna start using a lighter color. Like I said before, start bringing out the glow. The lighter we start going, the darks are going to be more pronounced, and we don't want them to be too strong. So it's good to go back here, just go over them lightly. That's too much. Just bring it down a little bit. Make it a little lighter. Thank you. Made two stars without knowing. Can fix that after. Shapes are getting a little tight, so I'm gonna use a smaller brush. This one's a number 4. You can see the difference now, again. Get in there, slowly but surely. Now, what I'm basically looking for is the large light shapes. In the beginning of the painting, we're defining the dark spots, and now I'm trying to define the light ones. And there's quite a bit here and there, a couple of spots. I don't want to make everything light. Another one here, you can just mark it like that. A couple here, a little bit there. There. Like I said before, you see now this part is getting a little bit too dark the lighter we go here. So I'm scumbling again, bringing that value to a lighter one. I'm quite happy with that. I think I'm going to start moving to this pile here. A lighter blue. The lightest after this is pure white. I might change brush in a second also. Define. Go between both this one and that one. You just watch where my brush is going, and there'll be no problem. I scumble, I go in all directions, but I'm trying to follow the shape of the area I'm painting. Again, the lighter we go, this has to go a little bit lighter also, otherwise it's going to be too dark. Careful with the edges. Go back to my synthetic nylon brush. To help me out, I'm gonna flip this. It's a lot easier light on. And I'm gonna give myself a bit of this white. Let me just place it here. Check if there's enough water in the paint, or medium, if you're into medium. I'm not. Water is my medium. Okay, I gotta be careful of my sleeve here. Yes, some white on this titanium white. Oops, keep knocking the camera. It's time to use a mall stick. Much better. I can see here in the belly button of the moon, you have these long lines from the strike. A comet probably hit the moon here. You can see it. Now I'm going to just... Yeah, this is hard. But not impossible. You just keep on trying. You can use your finger to spread it. And even to make it thinner. It's a series of overlapping lines. So I guess one can just make a couple. As you can see in the photo, there's a bunch of little white spots everywhere, like little highlights here and there. using pure white now. Mark this highlight up here. Take it easy, do it step by step and slowly, otherwise it'll be just a lump. Nice little edge there. And I rub it like this towards the inside so I can get a nice degradé from light to dark. So it blends, so it's not a very hard white line. Same thing here. I'm gonna use this brush to scumble it. The reason why I don't want to do a continuous line is it's going to look fake. You have some spots are lighter than the others. Some here, this one is kind of continuous, at least on the image. Okay, this doesn't work. I need this. I'll stop just about here. Thing's about to fall. Our full moon is nearly done. Well, it's pretty much done. Now I'm just gonna add some accents here and there where I see some spots. A couple of little details. I guess our full moon is getting pretty ready. Oh, this spot, I missed it. Much paint. Thank you. Okay, our moon is ready. So now for the land part, I'm going to be using a fan brush, but you can use a bristle or any other brush. In fact, I'm going to block the main part of the land with the number 12 Rosemary and Company. And for you to have an idea of the size, it's about a finger and a half. Now you can leave it as it is. You don't have to do a piece of land, but I want to do that. But this is cool also to have in your room, just the moon. But, you know, use your imagination. From here on, it's pretty much up to you. I think I mixed enough of this blue, but we'll see. Okay. Now how much of the moon do I want to cut off? Probably start around here. Bring it down. There's no way back now. So you gotta know what you want. Guess this'll do. To get some grass, but the effect of grass, you can use any kind of brush. In fact, I'm going to try the other brush I have. This is a synthetic, but it's quite teethy. Like, can you see? I'm going to try this one for fun. Yeah, much better. In case you're interested, this is a Rosemary & Company Series 2250. Time's up. Here's getting a bit dark, so I'm gonna do a little trick and use a lighter version of this blue. Here, then I can go back on top of it with a darker one. some gaps here and there. Just want to give the idea of grass. I'm not going to paint every single blade. Out of black now. You don't have to use black, you just put more burnt umber on this mixture, you'll get a nice black, but I enjoy ivory black. use a liner or a rigger. It's a very thin brush. Just make a couple of blades of grass here and there. This is just to break the pattern of the other brush. You don't want anything very uniform. Okay, now I'm gonna add some stars, and the trick to adding stars in the sky is to give them depth. If you paint them all white, it's gonna look like they're all close to you, so it's good to use some dark colors and then coming from lighter colors. So the lightest stars will be like the lightest color, and the further behind they are, I'll use darker. So let's start with the dark stars, and I'm using a very thin brush here. Just a very small round brush. I'm not going to add too many. We just want to suggest. Can actually get a star map and draw some constellations if you want. I've done that in other paintings. I'm not going to do that on this one. Okay, so I've done the darkest ones. Now I'm going to move to this color here and mix a little bit with this one. I usually twirl around my brush to get a very fine point. Okay, I just made a mess here. See, that one's a lot lighter than the other ones. And that creates depth in the sky. You can also create depth by doing small points and then larger points. Smallest ones will be further behind. And now I usually like to paint at least one nearly white. Could be Venus. Oops, that was too thick. To twirl my brush so I get a fine point. And a quick dab. Okay, I think that'll do. I'm not too happy here with this low contrast between the grass and the moon, so I'm going to lighten this area a little bit using the same technique, scumbling. Then I'll go over the grass again. This will also help to make this part light in case you want to put a silhouette of something. Then you have the dark against the light. If it's all dark, it won't show through. And I usually like to do that in a painting. Put something else here. You can put a tree or anything else you want, really. I think that part comes up to you. I'm still deciding if I'm going to do it or not. I like to leave this open to your imagination. And you can send your own message. Just spread the paint around thinly. Done a little bit here, so I'm gonna add a little back. Okay, so now that's done, let's rework the grass a little bit. Use a synthetic brush now. Good thing with the synthetic is not as rough as the other one, so to get a couple of lines, I can do this. Spread the paint and make it teethy. And then it's easier for me to make little grass blades. My liner. If I can find it. Here it is. To make some long blades of grass. Just quick upward strokes. To dilute the paint so it flows well. Here you go. I think we're pretty much done here. Okay, so now, if you want to do something like this, is usually the logo for my page. It's basically me and my wife, and I'm just holding her up in the air. And you can do something like that here. You can put a nice silhouette or something. I'll leave that open to you so you can decide. I hope you enjoyed this lesson and have fun with your moon. This is going to look awesome on your bedroom, on your living room, anywhere. And you can make it bigger also if you want. Just apply the same principles. Okay, I'll see you in the next lesson. Cheers.